Hello, everybody! How are you doing? It's Dr. John, back with more Pokemon Yellow. In the previous episode, we arrived to Celadon City, visit the Pokemon Market, which is pretty damn big here in Celadon City, gained some pretty neat TMs from it, from which I taught one of them to our current team member Terma so that we can cover up one of his weaknesses, and also we gained the new member for our team, Ampero Ticholtian. Easily and damn good competitor and possible replacement near the end for our Pikachu in our team. I know it is quite harsh from me to say that, but seriously, stat-wise, Jolteon just beats Pikachu in every regard. Almost every regard. I think Pikachu might have a little bit of special advantage, but it's really not that big of an advantage in comparison to Jolteon when we get to a little bit nearer to the end of the game where, let's just say, enemies hit hard, so their defense and overall, well, not to cause too much of a revision, but overall, near the end, it's the defense and power that sadly comes into quite big a part of the play, so let's enjoy these moments with Pikachu as long as we can, because someday the time comes when I have to choose between you and Ampero. But those dark times aren't quite around the corner for us, so we don't need to worry about that just yet, and instead here in the happy-tuned city of Celadon City, as you can probably see, we have a Team Rocket members walking around, and yet, no cops are arresting them. This can only mean that there's some sort of an undercover operation going on in this city, and as a 10-year-old boy who just happens to stumble upon this city as he's filling his Pokemon quest, he's going to do the job that the whole nation's police forces cannot do. Take down gangster organizations or mafia, as they, well, let's face it, basically are, taking down their operation. Yeah. In Pokemon world, 10-year-old kid can accomplish more for good things and acts than the entire police force. Wow! That's a new level of fail of sorts. Anywho, let me see. These are basically the two buildings that we need to focus on. This one here. This is the price exchange. And as for what prices do you exchange for what? Well, basically there you can gain Pokemons for the coins that you can earn here. Rocket Game Corner, aka the casino of the city. However, in order to actually gain any coins in that place, or more likely to be more accurate to store them, we need one specific item which, in case... Yep, it's this. We can get here if we talk to this guy. Go ahead! Laugh! I'm flat out busted. No more slots for me. I'm going straight. Here, I won't be needing this anymore. And we got the coin case. Now we can gamble to our heart's content. That is if we had unlimited amount of patience, because the thing is... Okay, first up, I'm just gonna show up the prices you can get if you have the unlimited impatience for this place. I'm just gonna show you just with what they're trying to lure people spend countless hours in the game casino here. So, the prizes come in two forms, certain TMs, or then certain type of Pokemons, and oh dear. God, okay, sorry guys, you need to excuse me for 1 second. Okay, and I'm back. Sorry about that, and I apologize in case you can hear the little bit of an something in the background. I actually had to turn the goddamn fan on because, as usual, it's hot as hell in my apartment right now. Anywho, sorry at the burp there. And again, good lord, I shouldn't really drink cola that much, but it's summer, what can you do? Anywho, now let's see if I can actually finish the goddamn sentence. The prizes here. I think here. Yep, this is basically, these are the first three Pokemons that you can get in here. One is Abra. So in case you are absolutely desperate to get one and just somehow always fail to capture it in the wild, then I guess if you want to spend countless hours in the casino, because trust me, already getting 230 coins in there is going to take quite a lot of time, then I guess you can try to get Abra for yourself from here. The other one is Bulbix, which actually isn't catchable in Pokemon Yellow. Well, it's one of those Pokemons that weren't included in this version, so unless you have someone to trade with for a Bulbix for something that you have and can catch in this game, then I guess you can, once again, if you have unlimited amount of patience, because yeah, 1000 is going to take pretty much 10 times the amount you need to take to gain 230 coins. So, this is your way to capture Bulbix, Wigglytuff. Well, there's really no reason for this. Wigglytuff is basically the evolution of Jigglypuff, and well, I didn't actually show those Pokemon. I didn't actually show you guys where you can catch Jigglypuffs. And I apologize for that, but basically, if you can recall the grass area where I was catching myself an Abra when I was showing that Pokemon glitch, in that same grass area you can find Jigglypuffs, so as long as you train them and then use a Moonstone, you can get Wigglytuff. A Pokemon that's easily available in this game, so yeah, I have no idea what the hell this is doing here. In the next corner, we have another rare Pokemon, and these are actually something that, I'm going to be honest, even I was pretty much not so awful at catching in the wild that I was seriously considering spending countless hours to get the money to buy these. Skyter and Pinsir. There is only one specific area in the game where you can find these, and they're extremely rare in that area, and also that one specific area has probably the most stupidest idea and system for catching Pokemons. Onto that one, only that one area in the entire game. What area am I talking about? Oh, trust me, you will find out eventually, and you will, most of you will probably share all the same horrid painful memories as I do from that place. God! And those who already know what I'm talking about, please don't spoil it for any newcomers. Just keep this sort of spoiler-free as much as I can. Anywho, so yeah, these are catchable in-game, but just very damn hard ones to catch. But this third one isn't catchable at all in this game, nor... Actually, I don't think this is catchable even in Pokemon Red and Blue, so this is basically a Pokemon in Generation 1 that you can only get through by playing countless hours at the casino. Parakon, normal type Pokemon with an quite unusual ability. Well, actually I'm not sure, or does it have that? No, it doesn't have that ability I'm referring to in this generation. It only came in on the 3rd and 4th generation, I think. Might have been in the 2nd one. Okay, anywho, basically, Parakon is... I really don't know how to describe it, like... I have never used one because I don't have this godlike patience that is needed to get this amount of coins from the casino. I haven't ever been even... never been even close to that. So, I really haven't had any experiences with this Pokemon. I really don't know how it plays in the end. But, from what I can recall from its stats and such, it's not that good of a Pokemon stat-wise. I think I could be wrong, don't quote me on that. But anywho, yeah, Pokemon that you can only get through casino playing. So, if you desperately want one, especially if you aren't seriously considering catching them all, good luck, and may God be merciful on your soul. And lastly, I think this is the counter that gives TMs. Yep, TMs. Now there is one specific TM. The two of these are kinda useless. Let me actually see here real quick. I actually have once again my old beat up guide at hand here so that I can recall. Okay. TM23 is basically a Dragon Rage. Not that good, it's a move that Gyarados and other Dragon types Gyarados and the Dragon type Pokemon learn pretty much naturally, always does 40 DHP always does damage equal to 40 HP damage. There we go, at least somewhat. That cleared sentence. Then I believe TM50 is... Ah, here it is. Substitute. It is sort of a good move, but I don't know. I think you can actually get it somewhere in game. But in case you don't, this is basically the only place where you can get it, but it's not that good. Basically, it does exactly what it sounds like. It can create an sort of a substitute clone when you use it in battle, which is going to take damage for you, so... I don't know, you can probably use it to avoid some very powerful attacks. But the one TM that I really want to talk about is this one, because this is a dick move. This is a TM not found naturally in the world. You can only get it from here. And it's the freaking Hyper Beam. Anyone who's played Pokemon should probably know that Hyper Beam is a freaking strong normal type move. And if you teach it to any Pokemon, most recommendably for Dragon or other as strong types, it basically just about tears everything up. It's freaking strong move. It takes a one turn to recharge hearts and it shoots on the next one, but that is a little setback compared to what it can actually do when you teach it to the right Pokemon. And in this game, in Generation 1, you can only get it if you have 5,500 casino coins. Wow! What a dick move, guys. What a dick move. Somebody at the game designer team was pretty damn mad at the day when they decided to do this sort of a little trick here. That is dickish. Damn good move, and yet it's pretty much unreachable. Because I don't have the patience to grind that amount of casino coins. I just don't. So, I'm gonna say this right away. As sad as it is for me to say this, no hyper beam for us. Ever. So yeah, kinda dickish. But enough of that reparaba, now into the actual casino. Now if you talk to some of these guys, they are actually willing to give you some coins to play with. Yet I think that was the first one. And look who is here also. So only enforcing his gambling habit and addiction. Hey! You have better things to do, champ making. Celadon gym's leader is Erica. She uses grass type Pokemon. She might appear docile, but don't be fooled. Even in gambling, he's still trying to give us tips on how to beat people's asses. Wow, that's some dedication. You're having a wonderful time, then you happen to find actually the one of the goddamn machines that actually work correctly in this place. Okay, this is the other guy from whom we can get coins. No crap! No really! Place is run by Team Rocket. Well, I could have never guessed. Oh wait. Yeah, I would have because look who it is right at the front of the poster. Anywho, let me see if I can quickly find the third guy who gives you coins. Actually, I think it's just those two that give you coins, okay. Oh wait, here's the third guy. Okay, I'm just gonna randomly pick one of these machines and show... I didn't mean to step out, get back in there. I'm just gonna randomly choose one of these machines and show you how this slot machine same thing works here. You basically pick a machine, and now there is no telling what machine gives you better chances than the others. It's basically the ultimate, well, yeah, okay, I don't know the fancy way to describe that, but let's just say you're really damn lucky if you actually happen to find a machine if that actually gives you at least some sort of a decent amount of cash. Because most of these are just here to rub you out. Basically, the idea goes that your odds are basically getting better and better the more coins you use. Basically, with one coin, you only get the middle row. With two coins, you get the middle row and the two sideway roads, and of course with 3 coins you get the whole damn selection. So basically with 3 coins you basically have the best chances you can ever have, but as you can see it still doesn't guarantee that you're going to win anything. So yeah, good luck at actually trying to find a machine that gives you some money instead of taking it away from you. Luckily it only uses the casino coins, because if these things were actually eating the actual Poké Dollars money, then this place would be a complete Rage Fest Palace. There we go. God, I don't know why I was stumbling there. Anywho, how about we actually get some action in this episode, and let's fight this Deutsch here. Let me just see. Yep, we're keeping Terra in the front line. I'm guarding this poster. Go away, or else. Or else what? You're going to kick our asses? Oh, I don't think so. Oh, I think it is us who are going to kick your ass. So anywho, this guy has pretty much the basic setup of Pokemon using an Rattata or its evolved form Raticate and probably a Zubat or its evolved form. They basically usually have either the fucking rats or then just combination of different type of poison Pokemons. And let's actually change then, let's actually demonstrate the TM that I taught to Terra to deal with it, the flying types. Rock Slide. Boom! One shot! Ha ha! And down comes the rocket. And if you thought that battle was easy, well, consider yourself lucky because you're going to get a series of those easy battles because for some reason, usually these guys have a little bit underleveled Pokemons at this point, meaning that you basically can kick them to the next Tuesday without breaking up freaking sweat, as long as you keep the Pokemon training to a reasonable stats. Anywho, let's split the switch behind the poster and voila! Secret door! And now, we are within Team Rocket's place with this kinda funky music if I say so myself. Anywho, taking out the door guard number one. This place is basically sort of a minimalistic. Sorry, I had to burp once again. Good lord, cola and hot weather doesn't really sum up together too well. Well, actually they do, but whatever. Anywho, basically this place is a sort of a little maze. You really can't get too much of a lost here, but prepare for a little bit of backtracking. You're going to do that quite a lot in these Team Rocket bases. Come on, don't get confused, thank god. Confusion doesn't likely do that much damage to you, unless you're weak to it, weak to psychic types. But it's that occasional confusion that really pisses me up about those. And let's bring out Cheap Breaker! Time to go down, bitch! And Bubble Beam! Maybe I should use... Yeah, I'm definitely gonna use the Tracker Rage to finish this thing off. Just to showcase what the move looks like. There we go. Dragon Rage, like I said a little bit earlier, only does 40 the damage, so it can be a little bit good of move to finish the fights or then trying to capture some Pokemons. So yeah, that's pretty good Dragon Rage, and now let's see, I believe in one of these plans here. Aha! PP up! PP is basically Pokemon points. With PP up, you can increase the capacity of one selected move of your choice. So if some of your Pokemons have some really strong moves, but they just don't have that many chances to use it or they're very limited, then you can basically use PP up to increase the amount of times they can do that attack. So really good item to stock up to. Now let's see, let's fight this Deutsch. Now I'm trying to... let's see, what's the... I guess we're pretty much reaching the 20 minute limit here. I try to keep these episodes a little bit more reasonable because, well, lately I've noticed that I published a little bit too many over half an hour episodes. So yeah. Let's see. Yep, we're going to change and let's actually keep Amparo chance sometime in the spotlight. I should actually teach Amparo some better moves now that we have him. But I think I might do that either off screen or in the next episode, because once we've cleared this first floor of Team Rocket's base here, I think I'm going to call it the quits here. Or just keep this episode not becoming too long. Oh, thank God it went down, because I basically learned to know that whenever those things get your health down to red or orange, they always use the goddamn Hyper Fang, which pretty much finishes you off at that low health. So anywho, here's an item which is escape rope. Pretty nice, nothing in that plant, and that basically just clears out the first floor of the Team Rocket space. Yeah, two guys. What a big freaking challenge. And yeah, their Pokemons aren't really that high level, so they're not. Basically, overall, these Team Rockets, outside the last guy that we meet here, aren't going to be that big of a problem. Or maybe I should specify that outside of the last guy, and this certain duo we haven't met for a little while now. I think you know what I'm talking about. Anywho, that's basically how you get into the Team Rocket space. And I think this might be a little bit good spot to stop the episode. Now I know I didn't get that much action done here, but still, I hope this was more than good enough for you today. So, on to these remarks, Dr. John, thank you guys for watching, and until the next episode of Pokemon Yellow, when we shall raid the Team Rocket's center of operation here at Celadon City, Dr. John, thank you guys for watching and saying bye-bye everyone, see you later!